Hi, welcome to this demo video for the guided analysis features in NVIDIA Nsight Compute. This demo will give a brief overview of how guided analysis works in Nsight Compute, and then dive a little deeper into the recent additions we've made in the latest versions included in the CUDA toolkit. Nsight Compute is a CUDA kernel profiler that collects metrics via hardware counters and software instrumentation. It applies built-in expertise to detect common performance issues and give insights into where they are occurring and some options to address them. This built-in rule set and guidance are what we refer to as guided analysis. For information on getting started with Nsight Compute, be sure to check out the quick start guide included in the documentation. Let's take a look at an Nsight Compute report for a matrix multiply kernel. In the details page, you'll find multiple sections. The specific sections you see will be based on the sections you selected when configuring the profile. The GPU speed of light throughput section is usually right at the top of most reports. It gives a good overview of GPU resource utilization. In this example, we see that SM and memory throughput are both very low. We also see a warning from the built-in rules, telling us our grid is too small and pointing us to another section, specifically launch statistics, for more information. There's an embedded link to take us directly to that section. In the launch statistics section, there is more information about my grid, blocks, and threads. A detailed warning provides guidance about the size of the grid for this kernel and additional advice on some options to try and fix the issue. After adjusting the grid size based on this advice, this new profile shows a much better utilization of the SM and memory resources. Next, let's look at a kernel that has multiple issues in the warp state statistics section. This section provides a breakdown of the states in which warps spent cycles during the kernel execution. For each state, the chart shows the average number of cycles spent in that state per issued instruction. Generally, the more cycles spent in one of the stall states, the more likely it is to impact performance. This example has long scoreboard stalls and text throttle stalls, with values exceeding their thresholds, creating the rule warnings we see here. In this section, the rules are sorted by importance so that users can focus on the topmost issue, since that's most likely to have the greatest impact. Here, long scoreboard stalls account for almost 23 cycles on average for each instruction. These stalls are related to the latency required to access the various levels of the memory hierarchy. This type of built-in expertise helps users understand performance issues without needing to be hardware architecture experts. Recently, we added a new feature to provide more detailed information on the built-in rules, including what hardware events are used in their calculation and what thresholds are defined indicating a performance issue. If the details are available for a specific rule, this button to display them will be shown next to the description. In this example, we can see that the long scoreboard rule triggered because stalls from long scoreboards were greater than 30% of the warp cycles per issued instruction and less than 80% of the cycles had active warps issued. This type of information is useful for multiple reasons. It helps inform users how these metrics are related to the underlying architecture, and it also presents explicit values for the built-in thresholds that represent performance issues. Users can see not just that they have exceeded a threshold, but also by how much, which gives an indication of severity. Another feature recently added to help users better understand the metrics, rules formulas, and underlying architecture is a knowledge base available by hovering over various portions of the report, like tables, chart entries, and labels. For example, we can see what metrics are used in a formula for any cell in the table, and also definitions for the various shorthands and abbreviations used to describe pieces of the architecture or terms used in performance characterizations of it, like wavefronts, caches, and processing units. The last feature I want to talk about is probably the most valuable piece of information available to Nsight Compute users that want to optimize their CUDA kernels, and that's the source code correlation and navigation. For many of the metrics and rules in Nsight Compute, there's a correlation to the line or lines of source code that are relevant. In this report, we see warp stalls from long scoreboards. The issue description explains that these are due to long latency memory loads, and there is a link guiding us to the source counters section. The table for samples where warps did not issue instructions shows us the top hotspots for these samples, and clicking on the hottest one, we go straight to the line of source code causing the problem. We can look at both the source and assembly generated by the compiler. Now, we know what the problem is and where it is occurring. The information in the warp state statistics section provided suggestions on how to address the problem, and there is additional information and suggestions in the profiling guide documentation. For example, improving the memory access patterns, ensuring memory accesses are coalesced, and reusing memory via temporal and spatial locality can all be changes that may help with this type of issue. After making the changes, rerun a profile to see the impact. Nsight Compute can even use the original report as a baseline and automatically calculate the difference between the baseline and this new profile. This demo has been a very brief introduction to the guided analysis features in Nsight Compute. In addition to the built-in rules, this framework is extensible via a Python interface to write your own rules and thresholds that Nsight Compute can automatically check against any new or existing profile report. Check out the latest version of Nsight Compute to make sure you're getting the most up-to-date guided analysis, as we're regularly adding new rules and expertise. Thanks for watching.